Hi, I'm Gaz, and I'm on a mission to train martial arts in every country in the world. In this video, I'm showing you the two sides to Phuket, the quiet old town and the lively Patong. Watch along as I explore the food, top things to do, and of course the Muay Thai training in these two areas to help you decide what's right for your trip. Hello everybody and welcome back to another video. So today we're in Phuket town as I got a pretty horrific night bus all the way from Bangkok. And we're going to be exploring the top things to do in some of the best Muay Thai gyms in the old town area. So instead of going to the traditional Muay Thai hotspots like Patong, Rawai, Bangtao, I've decided to have a more laid back couple of days. And yeah, soak in the vibe of the old town. The gym that we're going to this morning is called Phuket Power Gym. So when we decided to stay here, obviously done some research online, and this gym has some really, really good reviews. So some people saying that it's like a hidden gem in the Phuket Muay Thai scene. So I guess over the next couple of days, I'll be trying to figure that out if it is worth skipping the popular areas and coming down here instead. We have just arrived and it looks like a pretty cool gym. It's absolutely massive and there's a big Muay Thai gym in the middle, a fitness bit at the back, but me and Abby are currently the only people here at the moment. So if you know, you know. If you're the only people at a class, you get absolutely beasted for an hour. There's no hiding. But yeah, it looks like a vibe. It's one of those like traditional Thai style gyms as well, isn't it? So it's like kind of a metal structure with the roof on top, but it's all open, so it's absolutely boiling in here. Eventually the class filled up, so there were 7 or 8 people training with 2 coaches. After stretching, we started the main part of the class with drills on the bag. The coach would shout out a combination, then we would repeat it 10 times with some fitness exercises thrown in between. There wasn't really much technique shown and it felt more like a fitness or conditioning exercise. Overall, I had 3 or 4 really good sessions at Power Gym. The evening classes I went to were crazy busy and were ran more like a circuit class though. Whilst it was a good gym and everybody, including the coaches, were friendly, I just wasn't vibing there. Loads of people did love it, so why not check it out for yourself and see. After a quick shower and dip in the pool, it was time to explore Phuket town. Nice little centre water feature here, for sure. Pretty vibey.
Beautiful.
It is. It's always better when you don't even know it's there as well. We just turn the corner and bam, beautiful. So I was just trying to look up what that is, and Google was informing me it's busier than usual at the moment at the Golden Dragon statue. There's not one person there. The first stop on today's agenda is Phalang Road, which is this really cool vibey street here. So apparently there's loads of little shops, bars, restaurants, and stunning architecture to look at. So let's go and have a wander down it. We have got some beautiful soft serve ice cream. We've got a stunning building to take photos with. And then next door, if you want a quick doobie, a quick joint after your ice cream, you know where to go. Okay, so it looks stunning from the outside, but it's actually got a padlock on the gate, so it looks like we're not going in. After a quick walk around the outside of the temple, it was time for a rest. Where better to grab a drink than one of Phuket Old Town's traditional Chinese tea shops? Iced latte, and I've got some biscuits on the side. A little tea cozy. Yeah, proper fancy coffee, isn't it? Oh yeah, that is nice. It tastes like it's not too sweet and the coffee is like really like strong. You know, it's like a good coffee. It tastes like that. This biscuit here is like
sesame seeds and fluffy in the middle like a marshmallow. No.
I actually loved exploring Phuket town. The streets were a vibe and there's plenty of places to grab good food, drinks and explore. Okay, so after spending 3 days chilling in Phuket town, training at Power Muay Thai Gym, I've decided to make a pretty big change and head to Patong. So I'm on my way to the next Muay Thai Gym and I'm about to check out Chanrit Muay Thai Gym, which is literally about 10 seconds from my hostel. So I was actually gonna rest today, but I just thought, let's see where the closest gym is on Google Maps, and it said 120 meters. Got fairly good reviews on Google, so I thought, why the hell not? Anyway, I'm gonna take you guys with me, and I guess we'll see if this is another hidden gem in Phuket. Chanrit Muay Thai Gym is literally a 2 minute walk from Patong Beach and was recently opened by Chanrit Sito, a two-time Rajadhanam Stadium champion. I don't know what I was expecting, but my private session was one of the best hours of Muay Thai I've ever had. My trainer was truly engaged from the second I walked through the door. After 5 minutes of skipping and a few minutes of shadow boxing, he started working on techniques with me. Every minute or so, he'd dissect another part of my technique, correcting me, then we'd continue training. We must have done around 20 minutes of awesome technical work altogether. Next, it was time for pad work. No surprise here, it was super technical, and he focused on the areas he thought I needed to improve on, so pretty much everything. What followed was hands down my favourite part of the class. He actually gave me a 5 minute break to talk me through the rules of Muay Thai scoring in Thai stadiums. We then finished the class with technical work on the bag, where he was talking me through different scenarios and making me think when working. So wow, as far as hidden gems go, I think that was definitely one of them. It just goes to show that in Thailand, there's definitely world-class training around every corner. When I woke up this morning, I didn't expect to be dropping in to a Rajadhanam Stadium Champions gym, like on a whim. So it was absolutely awesome. And yeah, it was actually super technical session. So I wasn't gasping or blowing at any second. It was really nice actually, just to be in the ring moving around and to have the Muay Thai scoring system explain to me different strikes, how much they count, and essentially my trainer was just talking me through tactics on how to win a fight. Phuket is probably the number one destination for Europeans and Westerners to come to, and he was saying how many times people come in and think they've won a fight when they haven't. So he was just talking me through the scoring system and how different strikes will score differently, and just essentially telling me how to win a Muay Thai fight on kind of thinking and technicalities and stuff, which was great. After training, I spent the afternoon exploring Patong. First stop was the world famous Patong Beach, known for its not so golden sand and crystal clear waters. This was followed by a bite to eat at one of Patong's best local Thai restaurants, and apparently home to the best mango shake on the island.
It's good, it's good.
I then finished the night off with just one quiet beer that turned into a big night out.
Oh my God.
Overall, I love the vibe of Phuket town, but if you're on the island, I'd recommend exploring some of the more popular spots to experience the world-class Muay Thai scene. Make sure you hit subscribe and come back for next week's video.